Welcome, everyone, to NBA Basketball on 2K Sports. I'm Brian Anderson, here with Grant Hill, Steve Smith, and Allie LaForce. Hey, Allie.
Well, Kawhi Leonard has been called a cyborg for his lack of emotion on the court. He said, quote, "I just try to stay locked into the game. When people are the most serious, they play the best basketball. Nobody's smiling in the fourth quarter." Brian?
Maybe influenced by his years with Tim Duncan, who also had that poker face. Allie, good stuff. And while we have a second, let's take a quick peek at the rebounding numbers for Ivica Zubac.
On the board, he's had a much bigger impact these last few years than he did before that. He can be relied on now to make a difference with his rebounding, and that's a product of how hard he's worked down low.
Now the opening lineup for the Los Angeles Clippers. The two-way threats of George and Leonard are the wing pair. Morris and Zubac play together in the front court, and it's Jackson in at the point guard position. And for the Heat, Lowry and Hero are the backcourt. Jimmy Butler out there with Caleb Martin. And it's Adebayo in at the five, down low. Smitty, it can be pretty impressive to watch this Miami squad go to work on the offensive end.
Yeah, SBA, the reason why they have a bunch of talented shooters, that's for certain. But they also pay attention to the little things, like grabbing offensive boards and moving the ball around.
Here's Hero. The shot, no good. The Clippers go the other way with it. This, their first chance to take a look at the Heat this season. Jackson on the wing. Got a piece of it. Outside Butler. Three-pointer, no good. Leonard with the ball, picked up by Lowry. Leonard passes to Zubac. And count that. 2 points and a chance for one more at the line.
The strength and body control of Reggie Jackson gives him an edge against physical defense, potential and one.
One shot.
And Grant, a career resurgence for Reggie Jackson.
Yeah, B.A., after dealing with injuries, even at one point considering walking away from the game, he's found renewed success, and he's shown he's got plenty left in the tank.
A little over a minute gone here in the first quarter. Leonard against Lowry. They get the rebound. Here's Martin. Boy, he just disappeared against Detroit. They needed him. Hero outside. Let's go with a three. Miami, no good that time either. The Clippers have gone 1 for 3 so far. Here's Leonard, and you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a three-point play.
You see the power right there from Kawhi. Absorbs contact and able to convert right through it.
And Kawhi Leonard, one of three perimeter players to win back-to-back Defensive Player of the Year awards. It's him, Sidney Moncrief, and a young Dennis Rodman.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
And the free throw, no good. And for his career, Kawhi Leonard has more steals than fouls, Greg.
You know, B.A., he and Jimmy Butler, I believe, the only two players to achieve that after a decade in the league. A pretty remarkable achievement.
To the paint. Tipped. It's stolen by Leonard. Jackson against Hero. For three, George hits a three-pointer.
The D has to know where PG is at all times, especially when he's roaming around the perimeter.
Lowry finds Butler. Over Leonard. denied by Leonard.
A stellar defender. Leonard's impeccable timing on this end allows him to reject shots.
George outside. Jackson, the screen, shoots it from the high post. Adebayo against Zubats. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
They've controlled the paint so far. That's been the difference.
I'll tell you, this was their strategy coming in. They obviously identified a weakness there inside.
Time called here. Miami decides to talk it over.
Yeah, back in the day when I was playing, the Clippers were always an easy win. Now, LA is consistently a playoff team. Boy, oh boy, how times have changed.
And a little basketball royalty in the building. Dwayne Wade taking in the game.
Oh, Miami's got to step it up. You got to deliver with him in the house. And speaking of delivering when it matters most, his 2006 finals performance, one of the greatest in NBA history.
First quarter of play, and we're about 3 minutes in. Jackson against Lowry. Butler, a screen on Jackson. Pass to Butler. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Leonard. And it falls. 2 for 3 from the field so far. All right, guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Clippers.
The way they've been going after steals in this game, it has been super impressive. They are wreaking havoc right now.
Yeah, on top of that, they've been resourceful defensively, generating scoring opportunities by forcing turnovers.
Jackson against Lowry. Leonard with a screen on Lowry. Leonard, left side. The shot that time, not on target. Some solid defense from Martin. Well, we're more than a few games into the year. How much do we know about this year's rookie class, Grant?
Well, it's still early. We have to remember, we might be a half year into a decade-plus career for some of these guys. So I think it's best to reserve judgment for now. An NBA career is a marathon.
John Wall, he's checked in for the Clippers. Here's Vincent, Wall covering. Knocks it loose. Shot clock at 6. For 3, Robinson. Again, the Heat misses. On offense, here are the Clippers. A nice run going, 12 in a row. Here's George. And it falls. 2 for 3 from the field so far.
What a way to begin this game. Dominating at both ends of the floor.
They came in prepared, focused, and really jumped on the other team early.
Time called here. Miami decides to talk it over. And Grant, no team better than Miami at developing undrafted prospects.
I mean, for key roles, too. You look at last year's playoffs. Strus, Martin, Vincent, Robinson. It's allowed Miami to stay on top in a salary cap-driven league.
Deadman's checked in for Miami. And a new group getting ready for the Clippers. Batum has checked in for Zubats. Covington comes in for Morris. Mann, he's checked in for Kawhi Leonard. And Norman Powell subbed in for George. A minute 37 left in the first quarter here. Here's Deadman. And that's good. His first bucket of the game.
Way to attack the interior. Deadman really understands what the team needs from him.
Pass to Batum. Outside Wall. Here's Mann. To the wing on the left. Just five to shoot. Here's Wall. Nice start for him. Sinking his first shot.
This run has been fueled by their Matador defense.
Outside Butler. Outside Robinson. And he lobs it up to the rim. Up high and down it goes on the lob.
Nice pass. This team wants Duncan to do that more often.
Now Los Angeles with it. They're on a 16-4 run. Strus against Powell. Lays it up and banks it in.
Just so successful getting the ball inside and finding those great looks.
34 seconds left in the first quarter. Pass to Deadman. Now Butler. 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Six on the shot clock. And it's Vincent off the drive. For three, Robinson. Rebound by the Clippers. Coming off a win against the Hornets.
And as a rule of thumb, the road can really test your team's depth. But they all stepped up and collectively produced a lot of points.
It was really that second wave in the rotation that took the offense to another level.
Domination in the first quarter. It's been pretty lopsided. The Clippers on top. They lead by 14. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. Great to have you with us. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And guys, we've seen a confident-looking Clippers team out there.
They are looking engaged so far, especially on offense.
And that has helped them build an advantage here, playing with good focus and good energy.
The Clippers shooting great, 62% from the field and continuing to get it done. On the floor for the Clippers, the two-way threats of George and Leonard are the wing pair. Morris and Zubats play together in the front court, and it's Wall in at the point. Morris for three, and they recover it. Zubats passes to Wall. And here's Leonard. There's the three. Here's Zubats. Tries yet again, and the layup is up and in.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Well, guys, Jimmy Butler's focus is all on team success. In fact, his agent said whenever he calls Jimmy to congratulate him on personal accolades, like All-NBA team, for example, Jimmy hangs up in his face before he can finish the sentence. Brian, for Butler, there's only one prize that really matters.
Yeah, he's a rare breed, Allie, for sure. Thanks for that. Pass to Martin. Now Adebayo. Outside Strus. Down low. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two. It's going to be on Ivica Zubats. Well, an all-star appearance for Bam Adebayo in 2020. Grant, you think he can get back there?
No doubt. I mean, I think the bigger issue is we've seen his numbers taper off just in the postseason. Can he reverse that and bring his best when it matters most? Two.
Free throw's good. Adebayo.
Bam Adebayo gives his team so much flexibility, playing multiple positions and doing whatever the team asks.
And the Heat making a change here. Hero's checked in. Jackson, he's checked in for Los Angeles. And both free throws good for Adebayo. And Smitty, how about Bam Adebayo? He really diversifies this team offensively.
He does, B.A. He's a consistent scorer, and he's fierce on the defensive end, guarding smaller guys.
Jackson down low. He's guarded by Lowry. Jackson can't get it to go. And it's the Heat with the ball. It's a 16-point game. Defeated by Detroit in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
They failed to create enough good looks. The ball movement just wasn't quite where it needed to be.
You know, they take one step forward, two steps back, and exercise in frustration.
Here's Leonard. Really played well against Charlotte in his last game. Zubats with a screen on Strus. Here's Leonard. Blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the layup. Leonard's gotten four this quarter.
Their interior D continues to look shaky. Not a good matchup for them right now.
Leonard's gone 4 for 7 from the field tonight. Hero, the pass to Adebayo. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
In terms of offense, the Clippers have been up and down in recent years. When they're healthy, they're dangerous. When they're not, it's a struggle.
And Smitty, with the Clippers, it shows how important depth is to an NBA offense.
B.A., you know this. It's great to have a powerful first unit. But if your second unit can't carry its weight, it's a fragile situation.
The first free throw is good.
Bam Adebayo has been fairly solid from the line throughout his career.
And both free throws good for Adebayo. Well, Smitty, great teams have a plan B when the plan A fails.
Well, B.A., a part of it is coaching, but it's also about having the talent to win more than one way. Also, it's about ad-libbing and being able to change on the fly.
Hero outside. Pass to Lowry. Martin a screen. Launches a three. And he buries his first look.
The veteran point guard Kyle Lowry is terrific at setting the table for uncovered teammates.
Zubats with a screen on Lowry. And here's George. He's guarded by Hero. Shot from the wing. And that one's long.
Couldn't quite line that one up. Just got to shake it off and move on to the next one.
Now here's Lowry. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Adebayo, a screen on Jackson. Lowry, the pass to Adebayo. And is blocked. And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Here's George. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
Shooting one.
Few things get better as they age, especially in sports. Paul George is right up there with this all-around game.
And the Heat with some changes. Deadmonds checked in for Bam Adebayo. Jimmy Butler comes in for Martin. And Vincent is subbed in for Lowry.
What's up?
That's good from George. And again, Smitty, Paul George continues to impress.
B.A., what impresses me the most is that he's still competing at the highest level, looking almost as good as he was when he was an all-star with the Pacers.
Up top, Hero. Four on the clock. He can't get it to go. And Los Angeles the other way now. They led by as many as 18. Jackson on the wing. Powell outside. Three-pointer. It's rebounded by Dedmon. The Heat have gone 2-4 here in the second quarter. Here's Butler. And the layup is good off the glass.
A good interior scorer. Jimmy Butler using his strength and explosiveness to full effect.
Los Angeles has gone 0-4 from beyond the arc here in the second quarter. Covington, a screen on Strus. George for three. It's rebounded by Dedmon.
And you just can't afford to give up that kind of look very often.
Strus the pass to Dedmon. Hero with it. Dedmon a screen. Hero with it. Guarded by Covington. With the fadeaway. Here's Dedmon. And there's two. Work on the glass, paying off that time. Dedmon's got his second basket of the night.
Staying aggressive on the offensive boards. Dedmon's a tough guy to box out there.
Batum with a screen on Strus. Batum outside. Pass to Powell. Tipped away. Oh, it's stolen by Butler. Here's Vincent. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Dedmon, a screen on Jackson. Vincent can't hit. 6 second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Batum, defended by Dedmon. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Good vision, good decision by Reggie. Pushing for a better shot, finds an open man.
23 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Oh, Covington with a block. Jackson outside. Here's George. And it's good. Fought through contact, hit the shot, and will go to the line.
One shot.
That's good from George.
The all-around game Paul George possesses is so special. His versatility is what makes him so valuable.
Here's Butler. Ooh, he released it in time, but it's off the mark. And so that brings the first half to a close. Clippers ahead, up by 15. Well, now we have some time to check in with Allie LaForce. Allie.
Thanks so much, guys. Do a strong first half for this team. What was the mindset that gave you guys the lead?
We just had to be ourselves, you know, just be ourselves, move the ball, play the unselfish, and we're going to get ourselves on offense.
Stay true to you, guys.
Thank you, Allie. Good stuff. We will be right back after this break for the beginning of the third quarter.
And as we welcome you to the studio, we call your attention to the top performers for each team in the first half.
They've been assertive at the offensive end, willing and able to shoulder the scoring for their teams.
Yeah, they put on a show for us, Shaq. You know, it's something we kind of expected, but two great competitors are really going at it.
Let's turn our attention to that first half, which left a big deficit on the board for the Heat.
Well, they're not finding good shots, and that starts with their ball movement. Too much hero basketball. They need to sharpen up the attack. More motion, quick cuts, get the ball inside. There's no way they're coming back with that type of play.
Thanks, as always, for watching. Let's head back to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the second half.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly in the second. Paul George with a strong contribution so far in this one.
He's been excellent at cutting through the defense and giving them fits around the basket.
He's been very effective on the move, forcing the action, getting to his spots, and finishing plays.
On the wing, it'll be Hero and Butler. Bam Adebayo is out there with Caleb Martin. And it's Lowry in at the one spot. That's the group on the floor for Miami. A nice shot by Zubats.
And it hasn't just been their stellar offense. Their defense has been effective as well.
Yes, when it's going good, it feels easy. These are the nights you relish, but they're tough to replicate.
Inside. And Adebayo slams it in.
Wonderful play. With that long wingspan and huge hands, Adebayo catches and finishes with ease.
And at this point, they're loving this big lead.
Absolutely. And they haven't really faced a lot of resistance.
Jackson, the pass to George. That basket is good. Off the assist from Jackson. Jackson's got 5 assists in the game. Well, the Heat's shooting just 37% so far in this one. You know, thinking about the Clippers' history, those Lob City days really stand out, Smitty.
Yes, B.A., one of the most fun eras in recent NBA history. Blake and DeAndre throwing down alley-oops from CP3. That team had their own style, attitude. I love watching that Lob City group play.
And it's amazing. Their slim advantage on the board seems a lot larger than it is.
Jackson, the pass to George. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. And for Paul George, playing close to home on a title-contending team, it's a tremendous opportunity, Grant.
And back with the Pacers, he twice made the Eastern Conference Finals. But without a doubt, this is the most talented team he's ever been a part of.
And he makes a first. George hits them both.
What's really helped Miami over the last few years, they've had some of the most accurate three-point shooters in the league.
Now Butler continues to make an impact on offense, putting up 21 a game. Here's Hero. No good that time. And George with some nice D. And the Heat's ability to stretch the floor, it's critical to their stars' success, Smitty.
It is. Guys like Butler and Bam Adebayo, they thrive when they have room to operate, B.A. It's an approach that continues to serve Miami well.
Adebayo passes to Butler. Clock at 6. Back to Adebayo. The 3. Adebayo. It's good on the putback. Adebayo's gotten 4 this quarter.
A tireless worker. You don't have to call plays for Adebayo for him to score.
Pass to George. Shoots over Hero, and he was fouled in the act of shooting. Opportunity for a 3-point play here.
So reliable. They've really leaned on him at the offensive end.
Robinson, he's checked in for Hero. Kennard, he's checked in for the Clippers. Norm Powell comes in for Jackson. That's good from George. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by in the second half. They're searching for a way to score.
Yeah, buckets have been very tough to come by.
And here's Lowry. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. And Adebayo slams it in.
You see how agile Adebayo is. Excellent at slashing after setting the screen.
The Clippers have gone 3 of 5 from the field in this third quarter. George outside. Tries the spin move. Good D by Adebayo.
Aggressive mindset, but the defender just as determined to send him away empty-handed.
And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Well, guys, the NBA expanding its footprint through video games. Commissioner Adam Silver said, quote, there's an opportunity to capture a new kind of fan who isn't currently watching our games but enjoys playing NBA 2K. By learning about the players and the teams, they're more likely to engage in the live product. Brian?
Yeah, it goes hand in hand, Allie. Thanks. That was another look at our Mobile One drive of the game just a moment ago.
Yeah, taking the onus on himself to make something happen. Got it into the teeth of the defense and made them pay.
George for three. Bucket again. 7 for 12 and going at the defense.
He is starting to build up a little confidence. Hit just one three in the entire first half, but he has hit two more since then.
Outside Robinson. It's Martin on the wing. Got a piece of it, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Leonard. All right, let's see the best free throw shooting teams this season. The Heat in second.
And this is a team that knocks down their free throws at an elite rate. Whoever they go up against should always try to avoid fouling them at all costs.
Lowry outside. Five to shoot. Adebayo a screen on George. Lowry, good.
Their offense sort of clawing back to respectability. Let's see if they can keep building on this.
George passes to Leonard. With the drive, some solid defense from Martin.
A rare miss for him at point blank range. That's one he'd like to have back.
Lowry with it. A steady force on their offense, recording around 14 and a half a game. Los Angeles has gone 2 for 2 from deep here in the third.
And coming into the league, Kawhi Leonard was viewed as a raw prospect, a solid athlete and defender, but someone that needed to work on his jumper. Man, he has been locked in this quarter, shouldering the load at the offensive end.
Time called here. Miami decides to talk it over. And the Heat with some changes. Deadmonds checked in for Bam Adebayo. Strus comes in for Martin. And Vincent is subbed in for Lowry. .102 left in the third. Butler passes to Robinson. Here's Vincent. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. The Clippers have gone 5 for 9 from the floor in the third quarter. Pass to Wall. 36 seconds left to play in the third quarter of basketball.
Getting to the rim, Covington has hopped when he needs it.
Here's Vincent. Looking at his numbers. Currently, he's averaging around 9 points a game. And he lobs it up top! There's 21 seconds left in the third. Powell outside. Oh, and another three for the Clippers.
And when it comes to the three, they've been really dialed in here in the second half.
Butler against Leonard. To halt the run. No luck on that one. And so it's Los Angeles, up 25 big ones as we head into the next period. Their efficiency has been off the charts. They're running their sets well with patience and purpose. We're coming right back. Don't go anywhere. And now let's listen in to Ty Lue in the huddle.
Keep attacking, all right? Nah, come on, be aggressive, all right? Let's move the ball, let's swing the ball, move body, drive and kick, all right?
Staying focused on the task at hand, Coach Lue urging his guys on.
Yeah, all about focus and how you execute. When this team is playing together, they're dangerous.
Well, there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. So, on the floor for the Clippers. They've got Robert Covington. Terrence Mann is out there with John Wall. Then there's Nicholas Batum, and it's Kennard in at the small forward position. Los Angeles has gone 4 of 9 so far from the perimeter. Outside Wall. To the middle. Batum, the pass to Kennard. Outside Covington, 6 to shoot. Here's Mann. Offline with a three. When a team is underperforming, coaches are often the first people called into question. Is that fair, Smitty?
In some cases it is fair, but I'll break it down like this, BA. It always starts at the top. From coaching to your best players, they're always going to get the blame.
Pass to Wall. Kennard outside. From the arc. Nails it from three. Kennard's gotten himself going here. His first points of the game on the deep ball. First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth. Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Here's Vincent. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair. All right, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Clippers?
Something I've noticed is how aggressive they've been on driving the basketball. Time and time again, they've turned cracks in the defense into points.
Yeah, they've also done a great job of running. Attacking when they get the chance, always a great idea.
And the first one at the line is good. And that's good as he hits both shots. Well, Grant, I know you collect art, so we've been hearing all about these NFTs that teams and players are creating. I'm going to need a little instructional here. What's it all about?
Oh, DA, first of all, memorabilia and collectibles have always been around. But yes, NFTs have taken it to a whole nother level. And yes, I do have an NFT. I don't fully understand it, so I can't explain it to you. But I know it's the next big thing, that's for sure.
Here's Adebayo. The Clippers grab the miss.
And they're plus 5 on the boards after that rebound.
Batum, the pass to Wall. We're in the fourth quarter here. Just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Sweet little floater.
So physical for a one. Wall has the size and skill to do work in the paint.
The Heat have gotten just one shot to fall out of 3 attempts in the fourth. Here's Vincent. Hero, a screen on Wall. Shot clock at 6. Adebayo sets a screen. Hero, no good. Los Angeles has gotten 5 of 11 threes to drop so far in this game. Now here's Wall. Batum outside. It's intercepted. Here's Vincent. Wall covering. And Adebayo slams it in.
The emergence of Adebayo as a scorer. This franchise has to be ecstatic.
Los Angeles has gone 1 of 2 from deep in this quarter. To the inside. Covington. Oh, he powers right through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul, too. And he'll go to the line. It goes on Bam Adebayo. And we've heard the cautionary tales in the past. Does it seem like players today are getting better financial advice, in your opinion, Grant, to make their money last?
Yeah, B.A., I think they're getting better financial advice, but I also think that the times that we're in, I think there's more awareness. Players understand the pitfalls or potential setbacks, the social media, digital age, all the information's there. So players today, yes, they're making more money, and I actually think they're doing a better job of protecting and saving their money, too. And they're ahead right now because they're working so hard on the glass.
You know, you look at how they built this league. It's been through extra possessions. Mm-hmm.
Zubats with a screen on Hero. Out to Covington. This one for 3. And Hero grabs the board. Played it in with a nice touch off the window. Hero's gotten his first basket of the night.
Not lacking confidence. Love seeing Tyler go up strong with this one.
Outside Covington. Pass to Zubats. George drives in. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws. It's on Tyler Hero.
Strong take by Paul. He plays with great decisiveness.
First free throw is good, and the play-in tournament has been a success, but some debate about whether the stats should count towards postseason stats. Granted, kind of falls in the abyss. How do you think we should reconcile?
Well, B.A., first of all, it is the postseason. It's exciting. Everyone's watching. So much is on the line. This is high-pressure elimination games. And yes, there have been some great performances that we've seen in the play-in tournament thus far. So I think these stats should be included in postseason numbers for players.
Outside Butler. And he lobs it up, and finished off by Adebayo.
It's safe to say they have dominated this game. The game wasn't even as close as the score says in a great win for the Clippers.
And the disparity in the talent was obvious by the end. Sometimes you just don't have enough ammunition to compete.
Yeah, B.A., just a total beatdown. And the next time these teams meet, I can't imagine it'll be any different.
And so this will lock down their 15th win of the year.
Always good to start a season series off with a W. They show tonight they take this team seriously, and the next 2 matchups between these two should be fun.
And even the opposing fans can't deny this was a sensational game for Paul George.
He really played at his preferred pace, never let adjustments by the defense speed him up or slow him down.
Now George. Outside Wall. Adebayo against Batum. Here's Mann. The shot. Adebayo grabs the board. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Pass to Vincent. Adebayo against Wall. 13 feet out, and again it's Miami converting.
One positive takeaway, at least they're finally showing signs of life out there.
They put together some great possessions here at the end. It's a shame they could have used this run much earlier.
So it's the Clippers winning this one easily. This one wasn't even close. The hometown crowd was waiting for a miracle that never came.
Yeah, and this team was consistent throughout. They met every challenge, and they earned this dub.
Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Well, Paul, this team seems to be rounding into shape. What is your sense of the chemistry right now?
Really good, really good. Real beneficial. It's great that we was able to pick this win up. That's what it's about. We don't care if it's a blowout or if it's a close one. We need to learn how to do both. So it's great. We were able to pick this up. Good quality team win.
Good luck on continuing to build that chemistry.
Allie, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. So for Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Steve Smith, I'm Brian Anderson, thanking everyone for watching tonight's game. Last but not least, here is your New Balance Player of the Game, Paul George.